Hello everyone, good evening to all. Myself Dr. Chandrakant Pawar, Associate Professor, Department of Shalyatantra, PIR. And today I am here to introduce our guest speaker. Today we have with us Professor Vijay Kumar Biradar Sir, HOD Shalyatantra at NIJ College, Bidar, Karnataka. So I am here going to introduce briefly. Respected sir has completed his post graduation and PhD from same university, Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, and presently he is working at NKJ Ayurved College, Bidar. Sir has also 15 years of teaching experience and also guided 15 students. Sir also has operated thousands of cases, also including complicated cases of piles and fistulas. He has also honored to work as a chairperson in national workshop Nasyakon and Yogya Sutra in 2017, and also he has awarded with Kayak Yogi in 2018 in Sharan Sanskriti Sammelana 2018. So I welcome Dr. Biradar sir on behalf of our Parul University. I also welcome Dr. P. Hemant Kumar sir, HOD Shalyatantra, NIJ Jaipur, and Secretary NSA. And also I welcome our beloved Dean Faculty of Ayurveda, Parul University. Now I request Dr. Biradar sir, please share his views regarding concepts regarding concept of Shushruta regarding to COVID-19. So please welcome sir, you can start now.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chandrakant. So good evening to all of you. So first of all, I hope I have to join as Parama Pooja Sri 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 Dr. Shivakumar Mahaswamiji, the founder president of our institution. He is a great philosopher, philanthropist. Respected Dr. V.S. Patil sir, the honorary medical director of our institution, and he's a senior most person in the Ayurveda faculty, particularly the surgical discipline. Dr. N.G. Mulimani sir, the honorable principal. So I thank both the Dr. V.S. Patil sir and N.G. Mulimani sir for encouraging me for this presentation. And thankful to, I bow my head to my teachers, particularly Dr. Prasanna N. Rao, Dr. P. Hemant Kumar sir, Dr. Toshikane sir, Hemant Toshikane sir. So whatever little bit I know, so whatever little bit I'm doing in this noble profession, it's all because of their blessings. So I'm thankful to my colleagues, Dr. Chetan Nimbalkar, Dr. Ravichandra Mente, Dr. Mahadev, who helped me to prepare these slides within a short time. I'm thankful to the National Shushruta Association and the esteemed institution, Parul University, for giving me an opportunity of this guest speaker for this scientific session. Thank you one and all. So the topic given was Shushruta's concept of COVID-19. So Shushruta's concept of pandemic. Okay, as we all know that Shushruta was a practical person. He was a completely practical person, and we all accept that Shushruta was a father of Indian surgery. When we accept Shushruta was a father of Indian surgery, we have to accept even the concept of Shushruta's concept of COVID-19, that is pandemic. Let me discuss with you. So before to start, let me clear what is the epidemic and what is the pandemic. So the epidemic is nothing but the rapid spread of disease to the large number of people in a given population within a short time. So this epidemic is restricted to the particular locality, whereas the pandemic is when it spread to the countries, the continents, it is known to be the pandemic. And Shushruta explained this epidemic as a marakara. Shushruta, he explained the condition epidemic as a marakara. And the causes of marakara he has beautifully explained in the particular reference, Shushruta Sutra 6 by 16. So here I'm going to say, Tafam. Let me share a slide. Are you able to see the slides? I've shared the slides. Excuse me. Okay, so here I'm explaining that the epidemic condition is extreme dysphagia as a miracle, and the causes of maraca he has explained in the particular condition. In the condition says this. So, excuse me, sir, are you able to hear me?
Here, but slides are not. Slides are not visible.
Sir, slides है विजय कुमार बिरादर करके दूसरा एक है.
और बाकी को unmute कर लीजिए.
I've shared the slides.
बाकी को unmute करने के लिए वो. Yes, yes.
विजय यू कैन कंटिन्यू.
ओके सर.
इट्स विजिबल. स्लाइड्स आर विजिबल.
Here I am going to explain you what Sushruta explained the epidemic as a maraca, and the causes of maraca are, he told, Tesham, in this particular reference, Tesham Punarvyapada, Tesham Punarvyapada Adrushtakaritaha, Shitoshna Mata Varshani Khalu, Vipritaushtavan Tapakcha, Tasam Upayoga, Vida Roga Pradurbhava, Maraka Bhavadeti. So this is the reference, so told by Sushruta. In this reference, he says that the seasonal disturbance caused by unforeseen factors contaminating the water and herbs and the uses of the same by the population leads to different diseases and death. So, and here the Dallana, he explained what is that adrushtakaritaha. So adrushtena sarvajana samanyena adharmena, he explained that unforeseen factor is nothing but the adharma, and the adharma is nothing but the unrighteousness against the dharma. So individual disharmony with the nature, that which is not accord with the law, and that can be interpreted as the emission of the air pollution, land use, release of inadequate treated water, wastewater into the natural water bodies. So this is the maraca. So seasonal disturbance, so because of the unforeseen factors, that is adharma. So here you can understand this, the pathogenesis, okay, how the epidemic is, the maraca is going to occur. So because of the adharma, there is a seasonal variation by which there is a contamination of water and food, the use of the same by the host, which leads to the maraca. So even Dallana says that the adharma is nothing but the kaya vak manasa duscharitaha. So this is all about the maraca, what Sushruta explained. Okay, then. So come to the prophylaxis. What type of prophylaxis should be taken for this particular epidemics? Whenever there is the epidemics, so what type of early measure, the prophylaxis you are going to provide? So tasam avapannanam aushadinam cha apam upayoga, he told one should take the unspoiled food and medicines as a prophylaxis for the epidemic. Okay, tatra avapannanam aushadinam cha apam upayoga. So this is the prophylaxis treatment told by the Sushruta for the epidemics. Okay, then come to the pandemic. Okay, this is very important. Sushruta, he considered, okay, the pandemic as a janapada dhamsa. He used the term janapada dhamsa. So how this janapada dhamsa is going to occur, for that he has given different causes, that I am going to quote here. So this is a reference of Sushruta Sutra 6/19. There he says that kadachit avapanneshu ritusu, kadachit avapanneshu ritusu krutya avishapa rakshakroda adharmasya upadhamsate janapadaha vishaushadi gandha pushpena vayana upanitena akramyate yo deshistatra shwa kasa shwaso anuta pratishaya shirorug jarai rupatappante ghanakshatra parichay ghanakshatra charitaihi. So this quotation which explain about the different causes of janapada. So he says that sometimes without any derangement in the seasons, the population get extinct because of the krutya, the magic. So because of the abhishapa, the curse, the anger of the demons, the violent organisms, what you say, and the adharma, ill behavior or misbehavior. Further in the places or the locality affected by the air, laden with the perfumes from the flowers of poisonous drugs, people suffer from cough, the dyspnea, vomiting, common cold, headache, and fever, irrespective of, this is very important, irrespective of the constitutional and the humoral balance, dosha and prakriti. Sometimes they are subjected to the malign influence of the planets and the stars, and even so the bad omens which are present in the home, which will affect the pandemic condition. So if you look into the causes of this Janapada Dhwansa, the pandemic, okay, so these causes are perfectly, they are applicable, they can match with the country like China. So krutya, okay, the first cause is the krutya magic. So as you all know that the China is known for its traditional magic, okay, the black magic. So the black magic or the dark magic is nothing but the usage of supernatural powers for the evil or the selfish purpose. And if you look into the meaning of this China, as per the Hinduism, it is said like that, Kadi and Hadi. So it is a tantric division. The meaning of this China, according to the Hinduism, is a tantric division. And coming to the second cause, that is Abhishapa. So the Abhishapa is nothing but the curse. So as you all know that the China is known for its notorious wet market, where all types of animals were sold after killing. There is no mercy on animals. And even, so the China is known for the torturing the minorities. And coming to the third cause, Rakshasa Krodha, okay, the anger of the demons. So the mischaracter, okay, the defect in the character which will delight the evils. As, okay, you know that, okay, because of the misuse of the, there may be misuse of the viruses which may lead into, so the misuse of the viruses for the biological war which may lead into this particular Rakshasa Krodha. And even, so when there was the peak infection in the Wuhan city, the China declared the Wuhan city as a ghost city. They clarified that the ghost is nothing but the virus, and they vacant the city, that particular Wuhan city, for 78 days. Then come to the fourth one, the adharma. As you know that, okay, there is no freedom of speech in China. There is no freedom for the media. So China, it will invade the neighboring countries, and they put the technical hold in UN. So while declaring the Masood Azhar as a global terrorist, the country will support the terrorist. In the present situation, you all know that when the whole world is suffering with, when they are struggling with this corona crisis, the China country, so which is creating the tension in the borders. So by looking all these things, okay, so we can say that, so the China is the epicenter for this particular pandemic condition. So here you can understand the Janapada Dhwansa as a, so that these are the different causes which will cause the people, they suffer irrespective of prakriti and dosha, leads to the different clinical features like cough, difficulty in breathing, vomiting, common cold, headache, and fever. So these are the different causes which will affect the population irrespective of prakriti and dosha. See, the Sushruta has told a common samprapti for all the diseases. Okay, what he told? So whenever there is an involvement, whenever there is a visheshan of the doshas, he has told a common samprapti for all the diseases. That is, kupitanami doshanam sharire pradhavati yatra sangha khayoginnat vyadis tatroko jayate. So whenever there is an involvement of the particular dosha, you can plan the medicine. Okay, but here in this particular pandemic condition, he told irrespective of dosha. And when you are planning the particular treatment of Yuktyapashraya, the medicine, okay, it all depend upon desham, dusham, kalam, prakritim, where different things. Okay, but here, even the prakriti is not involved. So what I mean to say here, so this particular condition, this Janapada Dhwansa is an entirely different thing, which needs a different type of treatment, rather what we are thinking today. So Dalana says that, the krutya is nothing but the marana, mohana, stambana, vidveshana, uchatana, vashikarana, and abhishapa is nothing but guru, siddha, purusha, and prani, the curse by the animals. So these are the different causes which lead to the Janapada Dhamsa. Okay, that is pandemic. Then come to the pathogenesis. Okay, so how these organisms, okay, the viruses which will affect the particular population, by what intention it will affect the particular population. So Sushita has given a very important reference, okay, the concept of harmful organisms, so which clarifies that, which says what type of the self-hygiene, what type of measures, and how the particular virus, with what intention they will affect the population, that Sushita explained. So here I'm going to explain the particular quotation. Sada nicha nakaromna shuchina shukla vasasa mangala devata guru prena bhoitavyam kasya tat hetoho hinsa viharani mahavirani rakshamsi prati pashupati kubera nicharani mamsa shonita priyatva kshataja nimityam vrunina upasarpanti satkarartam jigansuni kadachit. This is a very important quotation. So in the early part of the quotation it says that, okay, the patient should cut short the nails and hairs, and he should wear the clean cloth, remain clean, should be indulged in the auspicious rites. He should devote to the god, Brahmins and gurus. Okay, the Dharmantri asks, why should it be so? So he explained, further explained that, so because, so the maliciously hovering, the virulent organisms, which are the associate of the Pashupati Kubera Kumara, to whom the flesh and blood are very dear, and they insidiously invade the wounded patient. Wounded in the sense, those who are immune compromised, weak patients. Okay, so they affect the wounded patient with a purpose to feed the blood, and sometimes with the intention to extract the worship and kill him. So this is a very important, how these organisms, they will affect the population to make him suffer or to kill the particular the population. Okay, and even so, if you look into the autopsy report of Italy in the month of February, so it suggested that there is a slime in the respiratory sac which prevents the gaseous action. The most of the death which occurred because of the, they says that the most of the death, COVID patient death, is because of this, the respiratory failure. But in the month of May, okay, the autopsy report of the German, so the autopsy report of the COVID patients given by the German, they says that there is a thrombosis. Okay, there is a thrombosis in the depth of the COVID-19 patient. If you look into the Sushita's concept here, to whom the blood and the muscle are very dear, moms are shown the priyatva. Okay, so there, the autopsy report says that there is a thrombosis. You know the thrombosis, the process of formation of the hard mass in the circulation from the constituent of the flowing blood. The mass itself is known to be the thrombus. It is a coagulated blood which contains the fibrin, platelets, RBCs, WBCs. And the cause for this thrombosis is the main basic pathology are any injury to the vessel wall, stasis, and hypercoagulation of the blood. If you look into the particular causes, as the autopsy report of the Germany, as well as the Sushita's concept, there is a link. Okay, there, the organisms, they cause the thrombosis, coagulation of the blood. So here, Sushita told, mamsa shonita priyatvat vrininam upasarpanti kshataja nimityam. Okay, so these virulent organisms, which are the associate of Pashupati Kubera Nicharani, they invade the particular population with the intention to feed the blood. Okay, we need to understand in a better way. Then come to the, so Dallana says that himsa viharani mahavirani rakshamsi rakshasa. Okay, so himsa viharani means Dallana he quote vada kridanani. Okay, this particular organism, it is playing a death game with the population. Then kshataja nimitta is nothing but the shonitartham. This particular virus, the organism, it is invading the particular person with the intention to feed the blood. That is, kshataja nimitta is nothing but the shonitartham. Then, so in Ayurveda, these virulent organisms are known by different names: anuchara, rakshasa, nishachara, pishacha. Okay, so this is the pathogenesis, how the virulent organisms, they will affect the particular population in case of Janapada Dhamsa or pandemic. Then come to the majors, again the pandemic and epidemic and pandemic, Maraka and Janapada Dhamsa. So Dallana, okay, he told ऋतुकोपस्य अधर्म कृत्वा तत्र दैवापाश्र भेषजम् द सीजनल डिस्टर्बेंस एंड द अधर्म विच लीड टू द मरका एंड जनपद ध्वंस देन द मेडिसिन इज ओनली द दैवापाश्र चिकित्सा सो इन केस ऑफ एपिडेमिक एंड पेंडेमिक caused by the disturbance of the ritu as well as the adharma then the only option of treatment is the dayapasra chikitsa the dayapasra is the only medicine and even tallana okay while committing the particular quotation which we discussed earlier the harmful organisms there he says that adi daivikam visishta agantu badakam so whenever the cause is the external factor the measure should be taken is adi daivika so he tells us that the dayapasra chikitsa is the main okay the treatment aspect in case of the epidemic and pandemic that is in case of janapada dhamsa and maraka so as we all know that there are three types of treatments available in ayurveda yuktyopashraya okay to the sharira whenever there is a vata dosha nimitta tattvavaida chikitsa there is a manasa rajastama sambhuta and the dayapasra chikitsa whenever the cause is agantu that is rutukopa agramadi nimittaha so as Nallana has clarified that okay so daivadikutam visishta agantu badakam and one more he told that is rutukopa adarmasatva tatra daivapasra bheshajam so then come to the what type of daivapasra chikitsa is explained by Sushruta so as in the earlier quotation okay Dallana clarifies that for this particular condition we need the janapada is our the dayapasra treatment and so here I'm going to explain you so what type of dayapasra chikitsa can be included so here this particular reference it suggests that tatra sthana parityaga shanti karma prayaschitta mangala japa homa upahara ijja anjali namaskara तपो नियम दया दान दीक्षा अभ्युपगम देवता ब्राह्मण गुरुपरेव भवितव्यम एषु साधु भवति सो दीज आर द सेट ऑफ क्लिनिकल सो सॉरी द सेट ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट्स विच कैन बी इंक्लूडेड अंडर द दैवापसर चिकित्सा दैट इज स्थान परित्याग चेंज ऑफ प्लेस स्पेसिफाइंग एक्शन अटोनमेंट प्रायश्चित्त ऑस्पिशियस राइट्स रिपीटेड रिसाइटेशन ऑफ द सैक्रेड मंत्र लाइटनिंग ऑफ सैक्रिफिशियल फायर offerings sacrifices salutation with the folded hands penance tapa niyama the religious observance daya the compassion giving charity so initiation from the preceptors then devata brahmana gopareya bhavatavyam so one should devote to the god brahmana and devatas so these are the different types of the what the treatment measures which can be included under the dayapasra chikitsa so let me discuss individual change there is sthana parityag is nothing but the change of place leaving away from the infected area so change in the external environment so by due to the nagna pada gamana so there may be stimulation of the pressure points in the sole so which may be benefited to the particular patient okay the particular the person who is suffering with the pandemic condition then shanti karma is nothing but the pacifying action shantir indriya vijayah getting control over the senses prayaschitta the atonement okay so prayaschitta is nothing but is atonement of the sins then come to the mangala the auspicious rites so mangala is nothing but prashashaushadi mani dharanadibhi so to prevent the vishama jwara from bhuta etc dharana of mangala aushadhi is advised example the sahadevi moola then dharana of tulsi bhen ear improves the immunity in children brahmi aindri jivaka vacha should be worn in hand head or neck so it will boost the immunity provide long life intellect health and protect from the demons and by wearing the manis okay one can get the energy so the energy to the gems then come to this japa the repeated okay the repeated recitation of the mantra so by the repeated recitation of the mantra so what happens a mantra generate the creative force and bestows the eternal bliss mantra is also called Adravya Aushadha. In the treatment of Agantuja Urmada, the use of Siddha mantra is explained. So here you can see the reference. The saying any mantra produces an actual physical vibration, calmness of the mind. Okay, that may be a Om or any Gayatri mantra like that. Then coming to the home, so there's nothing but the lighting of sacrificial fire. In Abhishapa and Abhichara, in Abhishapa and Abhichara, the home is advised. Then coming to the Upahara, the offering air, the sacrifices. Upa means the near, Kriyati to give. So until the Graha gets satisfied, one has to give the Snana, Vastra, Vasa, Mamsa, Madhya, Kshira, Guda, depending upon the days of the Grahas. Then the Gandha prepared out of Kumkuma, Keshara, Sarshapa, Yava, Ghrita, Madhu has to kept in the Palashapatra and must be placed in the place where the four roads meet together in Nirjana Pradesha as a bali to the respective grahas. So you can see the reference, Sushruta Uttara Tantra. Then by giving Upahara, there will be happiness to the mind and which act as a tarpana and prevents the disease. Namaskara, so salutation with the folded hands. Sharirika Manasika Vachika Namaskara to Guru, Dvija and Deva. So by pranama, there will be Dukkha Shamana. One will get relief from the bad time. Tapa is nothing but the penance. Tapa, Upavasa Adini. Upa means the near. Vasa means to stay. So meaning the attainment of close mental proximity with the Lord. So what does Upavasa do with the foot? The more you indulge the senses, the more they make the demands. So fasting helps us to cultivate control over the senses, sublimate our desires, and guide our minds to poise and peace. So Bhagavad Gita urges us to eat appropriately, neither too less nor too much, that is Yuktahara, and advises to eat simple, pure and healthy food even when not fasting. Then come to the Niyama, the religious observance and act of instance of following a custom or a rule. Daya, compassion. So he told, the Dalana told, Daya Praneshu Krupaha, pity towards the animals. Animals can be some of our best friends. They can be loyal to us, love us and serve us. Moreover, they can also defend and die for us. Hence, they have been used as a metaphor, the example to teach us positive values, behaviors and aspirations. And also, they show the positive ways to live and love our lives. Coming to the dana, the giving charities. So donation to charity is a major mood booster. Giving to charity strengthens the personal values. Giving to charity encourages friends and family to do the same. Then diksha, the initiation from the preceptors. So Guru Mantra, Guru Vakya, one should take the Guru Mantra, follow the Guru Vakya, which creates deep connection with the Guru and thus leads to instant solution for the problems. So, which creates a protection shield around the person that protect him from the negative energies as well as the misshapes. So this strengthens the individual at spiritual, mental and physical level. So that's why the Guru is known to be the God. Shivayeva Guru Sacha, Guruyeva Shivam Swayam, Ubhayorantaram Kinchinnam Drashtavyam Mumukshuvi. There is no difference among the Guru and Shiva as told by the Shastras. So one should take the Diksha during the particular crisis. Then come to the very important aspect. So Sushruta says that Devata Brahmana Guru Pare Bhavitavyam. So devotion to the God, Brahmana and Gurus. So in the particular reference, Sushruta Chiksasthana 24th Anagata Bhada Prachaya there. So here they have given, Sushruta has given the benefits. So what type of benefits you will get by praying the God, Brahmana and Gurus? He says that Yasasham Swargamasham Dhanadhanya Virudhanam Devata Atiti Pranam Pojanam Gotravardhanam. So by prayer one can get success. Okay. So over the evil invader, the heaven, longevity, wealth and offspring. So this is very important aspect of the Devapasvichikisa, that is prayer, devotion to the God, Brahmana and the Gurus. दैट इज यशस्यम स्वर्गमायुषम धनधान्य वर्धनम देवता अतिथि प्रणाम पूजनम गोत्र वर्धनम. सो द प्रेयर इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट ऑफ वयोवृद्ध चिकित्सा. नेक्स्ट कम टू द सो व्हाट आर द प्रोटोकॉल द एक्टिविटीज द इन्फेक्टेड पेशेंट शुड फॉलो व्हाइल स्टेइंग इन द वार्ड or you can say the home quarantine. So whenever the patient get affected with this particular pandemic condition, so apart from this devapasana chikitsa while staying in the home, in the isolation ward, so what type of the regime he should follow, for that Swastha has explained te santarpita na himsu. Okay, te santarpita atmanta na himsu. If the by performing all those devapasana chikitsa, those rituals, okay, if the viruses get satisfied, it has been said te tu santarpita atmavantam na himsu. If they get satisfied, they do not kill the discreet one. Hence the infection should always be vigilant and be surrounded by the people while living in a ward, provided with lamps, water, sharp instruments, garlands, string, flowers, fried paddy, and should be listening to the discourses which promote the prosperity. Okay, the so you should listen to the discourses. Anukula bhi katha bhi. Swastha has told clearly. Anukula bhi katha bhi. Priti manasa aashavan vyadhi moksha kshipram samroti. By listening to these discourses, okay, and the person who is willing to get from the disease, whose mind is calm, the balance, in such person the diseases are easily get cured. प्रीति मनसा आशावान व्याधि मोक्ष क्षिप्रम सुखम आपनुया. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स द पेशेंट शुड फॉलो व्हाइल स्टेइंग इन द वार्ड. एंड यू नो दैट द लाइटनिंग ऑफ लैंप इज पर्टिकुलरली टोल्ड बाय सुश्रुता व्हाइल स्टेइंग इन द वार्ड. आवर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर एडवाइज द नेशन टू लाइट द लैंप ऑन 5th अप्रैल. द इंटेंशन वॉज एज अ मार्क ऑफ यूनिटी स्ट्रेंथ एंड टू शो द and to show the positive mental status against the negative energy. So the reference, it is already given in Swastha Samhita. Okay, lighting of the lamp. Then come to the Vedic hands. Okay, the prayer for protection. Okay, so Swastha told the patient should be protected in the morning as well as in the evening, the true light. Okay, by praying the mantras of Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvanaveda by a group of holy people, priest. Okay, or you can say the Purohitaha. He used the term, the Dalana used the term Purohita for that particular Upadhyaya. So, while staying in the ward, the doctors or the priest, they should chant the mantras which are present in the Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvanaveda in an intention to protect the patient. Then fumigation for the sepsis and anti-sepsis. Okay, so Sarshapa Arishtabhyam, Arishtapatrabhyam, he told. Okay, so one can do the fumigation with these things. Fumigation should be done twice a day for 10 days carefully by mustard, leaves of neem tree, ghrita and salt. Okay, so you can advise. Okay, you can perform the fumigation by making use of these things for a period of 10 times. Then, to the benefit of aborigines. Okay, Swastha has given a very important simile. So this suggests that, okay, so what happens? Okay, what happens if you perform all the things which I explained in the devapasana chikitsa, as well as whenever the patient stay, while staying in the particular ward. Okay, he says that, okay, this is a very important quotation I'm going to say. Anena vidina yuktam ado eva nishachara. He used the term nishachara. अनेन विधिना युक्तम आदो एव निशाचरः वनम केशरिण अक्रांतम वनम केशरिण अक्रांतम वर्जयन्ति मृगयैव. इफ द एबोरिजम इज फॉलोड द ऑर्गनिजम्स लीव द पेशेंट इन द सेम वे एज ऑल द डीस एंड अदर एनिमल्स दे रन अवे फ्रॉम द जंगल टेरिफाइड बाय द लायन. वनम केशरिण केशरिण इज नथिंग बट द लायन. सो वनम केशरिण अक्रांतम वर्जयन्ति मृगयैव. सो इफ द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन हु इज सफरिंग विद द pandemic, if you follow all the regimens, all the measures which are explained in the Daivapasana Chikitsa, as well as while staying in the home quarantine or while staying in the ward, then what happens? The viruses leave that particular person. Okay, it's a very important means, nothing but indirectly. So it says that, so how these organisms, they get away from the effect of those regimens. So let me tell you the particular past event which highlights which signifies the importance of Daivapasha Chikitsa. So it was the sometime, okay, after 1910. So there was a epidemic condition in Shirdi, there is a cholera, and when the administration completely failed, they approached the Sai Baba to seek the help, and Sai Baba, so he went and took a grinding machine, a grinding stone, he started grinding the wheat to prepare the wheat flour, and at last he advised the four women to sprinkle the particular flour on the borders of the particular village. Then, so within few days after sprinkling, within few days there was a complete control over that cholera, that epidemic in the year of 1910. So it highlights the importance of Daivapasha Chikitsa itself. Okay, so this might be because of the divine powers, the supernatural powers of the Sai Baba, which helped the people to get away from the suffering. So this is one of the past event which highlight the Daivapasha Chikitsa, importance of the Daivapasha Chikitsa. And as I told, so the prayer is very important aspect, one of the very important aspect of the Daivapasha Chikitsa. Devata Brahmana Guru Parena Bhavitavyam Esha Sadhu Hoti. Okay, so here, so this is the study which was conducted in Duke University by Krukoff and his team, so which highlights the importance of prayer, how the prayer is going to affect in the healing process of the disease. So he and his team, okay, divided 150 men with chest pain into 5 groups, and all group had a catheterization. Okay, so all 150 patients of the cardiac, they already underwent the catheterization. So, and they divided into these 150 patients into 5 groups. In the first group, so the patients received the relaxation training. The second group received the imagery training. Third group received the therapeutic touch, which is the control group. In the fourth group, so these patients are prayed by a group of holy people, the priest. In the fifth group, so which is a control group, received nothing beyond the Duke's usual care. And let me discuss you what is the outcome. And the very interesting thing is, none of the patient, their families or the doctors, they knew that who was being prayed. Okay, then, so here the outcome, the clinical outcome says, somebody had to get a repeated procedure, had a heart attack, developed congestive heart failure, and died. And the results, when compared with the control group, so the control group is nothing but, that is what, the Duke's care, the therapeutic care. So when compared with the control group, the group that received the relaxation, imagery, and touch, Duke's touch, had a 20-30% of reduction in the complication. So whereas, okay, those who have been prayed for a group of holy person, okay, those who have been prayed had a 50% reduction in the heartbeat abnormalities, and had 100% reduction in the clinical outcomes such as heart attack and death. So this particular study, it suggests that the prayer is having a very important role in the healing process of the disease, particularly when it comes to the pandemic, what I feel. And since long time after this crisis, we all are discussing about the role of the psyche, sattva, the role of immunity, and the age factor. So Sushita has given, so he has highlighted the importance of the sattva. He says, sattvam saite sarva samstha abhyasa atmanam atmanaha. The person who is possessing the sattva quality can able to tolerate all the procedures. Okay, he may not be panic in a difficult situation. Sattve uttama manobalam. Rajasi, so for that particular thing, Dallana comments, sattve uttama manobalam. Rajasi madhyama manobalam. Tamasi mano dorvalya meyati. Tamasi mano dorvalya meyati. So the sattva, which plays very important role in the particular situation or any disease, healing aspect of any disease. Then come to the role of strength, there is the immunity. So here the recent doshas overpower the spandan. Okay. So here the Sushruta says that in particular quotation, so the recent doshas which are not going to affect the 10%, the one who causes the strength. And he says that, okay, whenever the disease doesn't respond with the medicine line of treatment, or when the disease becomes asadhya, he suggests try to maintain the strength of the person so that it can combat the severity of the disease, it can avoid the severity of the disease. He says that rakshayet balam chapi narasamittam tadrakshitam vyadhi balam nihanti. So in this particular quotation, he highlights the importance of strength in the process of disease, how the strength will contribute for the healing process, or how it will prevent the complications. And the strength can be enhanced by performing the yoga, regular exercise, rejuvenation therapy. In the relation of the strength and the vigor in relation to the age, so as you all know that, okay, the risk is found in the elderly patient. And here, between 60 to 40, the strength maintained, and from 40 to 70, there is a deterioration of the strength. And Sushruta says that after the age of 70 years, every day there is a decrease in the strength. So that for that, the elderly patients are more risk to develop any disease, or maybe they do suffer with this pandemic condition. So then coming to the conclusion, Janapada Dhamsa, the pandemic arises due to serious violation of the universal principles, that is adharma. So where the Vaidyapasana Chikitsa is the only solution. All the spiritual therapies explained under the Vaidyapasana Chikitsa provide the psychological stability, purity, immunity, and the grace of Almighty. He who from the depth of his soul seeks to know God will certainly realize him. He must. So here, you need to pray the God with the soul, as Sri Ramakrishna told. So this is the conclusion of this particular presentation. And these are the suggestions. So I would like to suggest these things out of this particular presentation. Dharmo rakshati rakshataha. So dharmo rakshati rakshitaha. If you protect the dharma will protect us. So this is the time to live the dharma jyoti. Even though with the top health facilities, the many affected countries are unable to find a particular medicine, the solution for the COVID-19. Okay, so the world need to understand, I want to say here, the world need to understand that this is not a common disease to treat with the medicine, rather to realize that this is a karma janna vyadhi, adharma janna kruta, and the solution is the only surrender to the God, Daivapasya Chikitsa. As you all know that since long time, the most of the countries who are affected, they are trying to find out the particular vaccine, but till today they couldn't, because this particular condition is a different entity. So that the world need to understand what I mean to say. Then come to the, so we need to understand the fundamentals of the climate, why and how the climate is going to vary. So how the people are polluting the climate. So what type of steps to be taken to protect and to maintain the natural climatic conditions. And we should understand that the nature is nothing but the God. We have to pray and protect it. So this is the time to follow the lifestyle of our ancestors who lived happily, healthy, and long life. So an optimal state of the health or the swastha according to Ayurveda or according to Sushruta can only be achieved when there is a proper balance of these three pillars, Trayopastamba, Ahara, Nidra, and Brahmacharya. So this is the time to follow the ancient system of the medicine, okay, the Ayurveda, which promotes the health and cures the disease without causing any adverse effect. So these are the suggestions which I would like to give to everyone, or even to the Ayush ministry. Then the area of research. Okay, what type of research required? A multidimensional studies are necessary to understand the effect of the Vaidyapasana Chikitsa. Study related to the violation of the universal principles like nature, human rights, crime rate, okay, so the violation to the spirituality. So particularly in those countries, okay, which are highly affected by the pandemic, like China, Italy, USA, which is required. Research in the area which promote the immunity, mental stability, quality of life is required. So these are the areas which one has to concentrate. So thank you, Anandam. So once again, I'm very thankful to the National Swachhata Association and the esteemed university, Paul University, for providing me an opportunity of this presentation. I'm also thankful to all the faculty members and students who joined this particular presentation. I thank for your patience hearing. Thank you, Anandam.
Thank you, sir. Now the session is open for question answers. If any of the viewer have a question, then they can ask. I think there are no viewers has any questions. So I would like to request P. Hemant Kumar sir to say a few words.
I think there is some questions in chat box.
Yes sir, there is a question from Rohin Mujawar. How about the role of Dinacharya in tackling such a pandemic?
So, see, definitely, so as I told in the conclusion, this is the time we have to follow the lifestyle of our ancestors. Okay, we have to follow the things which have been told in the Ayurveda.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So, which includes the Dinacharya as well as the Rutucharya. But particularly, okay, so in the management of pandemic, Janapada Dhamsa, Sushruta told the Daivapasya Chikitsa, Rutukopasya Adharmatva Tatra Daivapasya Bheshajam. The treatment for pandemic Janapada Dhamsa is only the Daivapasya Chikitsa. One should surrender to the God. As the enemy, this particular virus is in it. So if the enemy is visible, we can fight. This is invisible. This is the evil spirit. And to combat this evil spirit, we need the God spirit. Okay, you cannot treat with the medicine. So you know, so near about 100 years back, there was a flu in the Spain, which killed around 10 crore people throughout the world. Till 100 years, we are not in a position to find out a particular medicine or the vaccine, because this particular pandemic condition is entirely different. It is Agantuja. Okay, if you look into the treatment of Unmada, Agantuja Jwara, Abhishapada Jwara, the treatment told is Dharapasya only.
Yes.
And then particularly I told, this particular condition is going to occur irrespective of dosha and prakriti. Dosha prakriti avasheshena. Here there is no pathogenesis at all. There is a rapid spread of disease. All of a sudden, the whole population, they lost, they extinct.
Thank you, sir. There is another question from Amol Podole. If there is a correlation between COVID-19 to Vat Kapha Pulban Sannipatak Jwara?
COVID-19 is the Vata?
Vat Kapha Pulban Sannipatak Jwara.
So it's very difficult to make the correlation, as I told. Okay.
Yes.
Now, if I told, there is no involvement of the dosha, there is no pathology at all. And you might have seen most of the patients, COVID-19 patients are asymptomatic. Yes. Okay, how can you plan the treatment as a Vata, Pitta, and Kapha when the patients are asymptomatic and there is no linga at all?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So I think there is no more question.
I wonder most of the people, they are behind the medicine. Okay, they are behind the medicine. They are not thinking in this particular way. What Sushruta has particularly told about the Maraka and Janapada Dhamsa. Why can't they are following this particular treatment?
Yes, yes, sir, yes.
He told Sthana, Parityaga, Shanti Karma, Japa, Homa, all these things have been told under the Daivapasya Chikitsa. If you advise the patient or the person to follow this particular the set of treatment, definitely he will come out of this particular situation. But nobody is ready to follow or express regarding this particular type of treatment what Sushruta has given.
Yes. Yes, sir. There is a more question.
No, definitely, please.
Now the question is from Ritesh Samlecha. He is asking about explain Dupan karma, that is fumigation in COVID-19 disease.
See, Dupana particularly, so in the, as I explained in the treatment aspect, okay, so Dhrupana is indicated whenever the patient is staying in the ward. So to avoid the infection when he is staying in the ward, the Dhrupana has been explained. Otherwise, Sushita told Ijja, Homa, that is sacrificial fire. If you do the sacrificial fire, definitely, so it will clean the environment. Okay, the God will get the strength. Okay, even you get the grace of the God.
Yes.
There is the Homa Yagna. So one more thing I would like to tell you that, so in the some part of the Karnataka, particularly in the villages, okay, some of the farmers, they are doing the Homa with the help of Ghruta and cow dung, and that particular village is free of this particular pandemic condition. They are performing the Homa by chanting some of the mantras. They do follow. Being we Ayurveda, we are not adapting and we are not ready to talk about this particular Yagna, Homa, Daya, Dana, Diksha, Abhyupagama.
Yes. I think, sir, all question has completed. Now I would like to thanks once again to Biradar sir for sharing his very valuable thoughts and also elaborating in such a way by touching all the aspects of treatment. And also elaborating COVID-19 as a Janapada dance and the spirituality and importance of prayer, which are very much essential and are the need of an hour. Thank you very much for such a wonderful and such a fruitful and knowledgeful lecture. And
another two questions are there. Please,
sir, please, sir, please. Chat
box. Sorry.
Dr. Rajendra Paliwal and Dr. Archana.
Okay, now. Recently. Okay. Is there any reference of reference of isolation or quarantine in case of epidemic other than Sushruta Kushta chapter?
Kushta chapter.
Yes, yes. Kushta chapter, is there any reference regarding isolation or quarantine?
Regarding isolation and quarantine, I think, I don't know exactly, but one thing what I know is, in the chapter of Kushta, in the mandate of Kushta, if the Kushta is not responded by means of medicine, so one has to go for the Daivapasach chikitsa. In the Kushta also, okay, so the Daivapasach line of treatment is explained. When? If the patient won't respond by means of medicine line of treatment. Regarding the isolation of the ward in Kushta, I don't know exactly. Okay.
Okay. Next question from Archana Jangit. What is the role of Panchakarma in treating any epidemic disease?
So I told, okay, so this is not a common disease to treat with the medicine line of treatment. This disease is because of the adharma, the violation of the universal laws. It's a karmika vyadi. Okay, it's a karmika. So few people are not accepting this particular, because we are very advanced. So we are thinking everything on the basis of scientific ground. We are assessing the things with the mind, not with the heart. So this in the cause itself, it told kritya, abhishapa, adharma, rakshasa, krodha. Okay. Dosha prakritya avisheshena. Rasa, Shwasa, Omutu, Pratishaya, Jvara. So these things, they occur without any the dosha dosha samushtana. There is no pathology at all. Then how can you plan the panchakarma? I wonder, how can you plan the panchakarma? See, thousands of people dying in one day throughout the world. So how can you plan this epana, all these things for a period of 7 days, 15 days? Within seconds, the people are dying. More than 3-4 million of the people, they die till the date.
Yes, thousands
of people are dying till every day. Can you plan the panchakarma? And what about dosha you are going to evaluate? Already it is told, dosha prakutya visheshena. So I don't think that there is a role of panchakarma. There is no role of yukti upasara chikitsa. in this particular Janapada Dhwansa or the Maraka. If you look into the, that's why I told, okay, the references, Sai Baba, how he controlled that particular plague when the administration failed by medicine. Yes. There are a lot of studies which have been already conducted in so many universities, how the prayer will help in the healing process. Okay, particularly I don't know, in pandemic condition, so it is having a role in all the diseases, not only pandemic. Moreover, I think it is most effective in pandemic because it is adharma krita. In the condition of, because of the adharma krita, definitely the prayer, what the Sushruta has told, it will have more influence in controlling the condition, the crisis.
Okay, thank you, sir. One more question from Himadri Mudgal. She is asking, sir, which dravyas we can use as in Dupana Karma, for Dupana Karma, which dravyas we can use?
So you can use the combination of Sarshapa, Nimbapatra, Ghata and Saindava Lavana.
Yes.
So Sushruta told two times for a period of 10 days. The Dhupana should be performed in the morning and evening in the ward for a period of 10 days.
Yes, sir. Next to that, there is a question from Shekhar Patel.
Yeah.
Is there any relation of Prakruti with having COVID-19 disease, or which Prakruti people are more prone to this disease?
Once again, I am repeating, there is no role of Prakriti. Okay, the yes. role of Prakriti comes when you plan for the Yukta Pachra Chikisa. Desham, Dosham, Kanam, Ananam, Prakriti, Vaya. So 11 factors. Here there is no involvement of the Prakriti. Irrespective, I told, irrespective of Prakriti and the Dosha. Okay, there is no role of Prakriti. And moreover, you might have seen, okay, most of the children, the policemen, the infection even spread to the BSF shoulder, the soldiers. Okay, the military people, it is not thinking that you are having the strength, it is not thinking that it is whether the person is a child or he is a strengthful or elderly. Of course, okay, in general, what Sushruta told, the elderly people are more prone to develop this particular condition. Okay, the more risk is found in the elderly patient because there is a lack of strength. I don't think that there is a role of Prakriti.
Yes.
There is no role of Prakriti at all. There is no role of Dosha. Dusha at all. There is no pathology at all. So I told in the early, it is a pandemic condition, rapid spread of the disease within a short time. It will affect the population within a short time. Within a day, the most of the people will die. Okay, that's why I have given the reference of the Spain flu. In 1910, 10 crores of people, they died throughout the world within few days, within few days.
Yes.
There is no rule at all.
Yes, sir. There is another question from Ishkinda Pankaj. She is asking about Patya during COVID-19 situation. Again, she is asking for Patya.
See, it has been told. So whenever someone is suffering with some particular disease, Sushita told, Dirga Shalodhanam Stignam Ustam Alpam Chabhojanam Unjano Janglai Shigram Vranam Uppahet. Okay, so whenever there is a lack of Agni, so whenever you are suffering with particular disease, so one should take Laguhara, Dirga Shali, Dirga Shalodhanam Stignam Ustam Alpam Chabhojanam, which is in sensory liquid, liquid diet. Okay, otherwise you can make use of the soup which is prepared of Jangla Mausa. So the intention is to enhance the Agni. As you all know that, Roge Sarve Api Mandagnisha. The Mandagni is the cause for almost all the diseases. So in case of any disease, so the patient should follow this particular type of food. Okay, Laguahara. Okay, Ushnodaka. Laguahara.
Yes. There is another question which is quite different. That is, in present time, how we can increase our sattva?
Okay, in present time, how we can increase our sattva? Okay, the sattva you can increase by performing the same thing what I'm telling. Okay, Anjali, Namaskara, Ijja, meditation. So the meditation is the best way to control over the senses. Shanti karma, he told in the beginning itself. Shanti karma is nothing but the indriya vijaya. You can have a control over your senses. Okay, how? If you meditate satata, okay, the regular. So regular meditation definitely will help you to increase your sattva.
Definitely.
Or even the yoga. Okay, if you perform the yoga, if you perform the puja, so all these things, what I explained in the under the heading of the Dayapasa Chikitsa, they all increases the sattva itself. Okay.
Yes, sir. Now there is a question from Indira Mishra from NIA Jaipur. He is asking, it is possible for COVID-19 to enter human body through skin wounds?
Through?
Skin wounds.
Skin holes. Okay.
Wounds.
Yeah. See, I told. Okay, the present, the autopsy reports of the COVID-19 patient in the month of May in German, they said that there is a thrombosis. Okay, so there is a thrombosis. The virus, it affected the particular blood. So in the earlier report says that it will affect the respiration. Okay, respiratory system, most of the death because of the pneumonia. Okay, so if you look into these things, okay, the virus, it may take entry from any natural passages, maybe from the mouth as droplets or respiratory passage, maybe ulcer. Kshataja nimittam, he told Sushruta. Okay, kshataja nimittam vraninam upasrampanti satkarartam jigansuni kadachit. Okay, whenever the patient is suffering with the ulcer, the particular organism, it will take entry through the ulcer. Okay, wherever there is an open passage, it will take entry. I don't think it is through the air pores. Okay, it is a protective barrier. The skin is a protective barrier.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, there is a question from Nanda Patil. She is asking, she is asking, Dravya Vipassana Chikitsa is helpful in preventing further development of disease. Does it work in COVID-19 positive patients?
I believe that definitely if you follow the Sushita's concept of Dravya Vipassana Chikitsa for the Janapada Dhwansa pandemic, definitely we can overcome. And this particular concept, okay, I sent to the Ayush Ministry as well as the state authorities in the month of April 11th. But in the Ayush advisory, it has not been included, unfortunately. Because that's why what I'm telling, we people become more advanced. So whatever scientific, we accept.
Yes, sir. Thank you. There is no another question, sir, in chat box.
Okay.
Now, I would like to request.
It has no meaning.
So before that, I would like to say something. Really, I'm very grateful that. Okay, I'm very happy that the Parul University, particularly Dr. Hemant Toshikane sir and the P. Hemant Kumar sir, so they are conducting the series of guest lecture webinar since long time. So it's a great effort. It's nothing but the Ayurveda mantra, how the Kshirasagra mantra was took place, through which the Dhanvantri, okay, Dharma Sambhutaha, he evolved. So really the same thing these people are doing. I'm very thankful, definitely. So this particular subject of the guest lecture, the series of guest lecture, they will boost the students, okay, the students when they are staying in the home.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, we are also very, very much thankful to you, sir, for sharing your very valuable thoughts and all the aspects you have covered, and also the aspects which are very much needed, and those are very need of our, so spirituality, prayer, and Deva Vipassana Chikitsa, which are always helpful to such a kind of situations. So we are very, very much thank you, sir. On the behalf of Parul University, I once again thank you to डॉक्टर विजय कुमार बिरादर सर एंड ऑल्सो नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट पी हेमंत कुमार सर से फ्यू वर्ड्स.
And first of all, I highly appreciate Dr. Vijay Biradar. I think he proved Susuta is not only a surgeon, not only a physician, not only a skilled technician, and he is not only a philosopher, but he proved that he is an epidemiologist. And he proved that he is a spiritual person to highlight about the Daivapasrika Chikitsa. And really, it is a very great task. And I, first of all, I appreciate Dr. Vijay Biradar. I ask you to take some guest lecture. Usually, if any surgeon, they will take about any surgical procedure or anorectal procedure or maybe some parasurgical procedure like that. And you told that, sir, I will take the class on Susuta's concept of COVID. So really, it is a very interesting topic and very important. I appreciate Dr. Vijay. I think some few people knows about he is the best woundologist. He studied maximum work on research works on wound. If you go, sir, if you go for in Google also, there are so many articles he published. And also another thing, he is the first person in India worked on Virechana Karma in the management of Dushtavarna. So really, he is a very dedicated teacher and is motivated. And I appreciate wholeheartedly for his sincere efforts to prove that our concepts also helpful for this COVID conditions, and really appreciate. And before concluding, I request two persons. One is Dr. Jnaneshwar. I think Jnaneshwar is there. Hello? Hello, Jnaneshwar sir, boss, is there? Hello, Dr. Jnaneshwar.
Yes, hello. Good evening.
Boss, namaskar, boss. Jnaneshwar is my senior boss. And recently he affected COVID positive, and he is a very senior surgeon in Warangal, leading practitioner. He is, I proud to say, is my boss, my senior, and is Ayurvedic surgeon, and recently suffered with COVID. Please kindly share your experience, boss.
It's really excellent, because one thing, it is a very exhaustive topic.
COVID affected muscle.
One has to follow the Daivapasara Chikitsa, which is very much widely described by the Susuta in 2-3 chapters, and hymens also he has given. Many hymens also have been given in the Susuta and during the operation theater and before doing the any surgeries. He has given, and Samprokshana also has given. Dr. Vijay has given very, very good details regarding this Daivapasrika. Thank you for Dr. Vijay, and also for the conducting such a very good initiative by the National Susuta Association, Dr. Hemant. Thank you for.
Okay. Thank you, boss. And I request V.S. Patil sir, please conclude this. V.S. Patil sir. Hello.
Hello.
Patil sir.
Sir Pawar sir. Hello.
Hello.
Sir. Shall we conclude, sir?
Yes. Okay. We can conclude it. I think.
Yes. Sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Sir. Yes. Yes. Okay.
Sir, so we are going to conclude. So I am thankful to Dr. P. Hemant Kumar sir, Secretary, National Susuta Association, and for opening such a platform for all the Shalya Tantra students and all the fraternity, and. I also thankful to our dean Hemant Kumar sir Dr. Hemant Kumar sir for offering me such a great opportunity to have such a nice session, to be a part of such a nice session. And I also request to all our participants to please do registration for National Sushruta Association and be a part of such a great organization. So thank you all, the viewers also, for participating this event. So I again thanks on the behalf of Parul University, and I also very much thankful to our management for supporting us for such events. So thank you all, and now we are going to conclude this session. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Okay.